Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, who is the most gracious and merciful. Assalamu alaikum, students. I hope you will be fine by the grace of Allah. I am teacher of Muhammadi Girls School. I will teach you English, class 3. Topic is essay writing. Before starting the lesson, I am giving you some instruction. Kindly listen me very carefully. Check your audio setting and use hands-free for clear voice. Check your audio setting and use hands-free for clear voice. Keep your active English course book, pencil and notebook with you. If you want to ask any question, you can ask at the end by raising hands. Make two portions in your copy, one for text and one for composition site, where essay, application and letter will be done. Home task will be done in your fair copy. Dear student, today I will teach you about the essay writing, how to write the essay. Topic name is my family. Okay. Dear students, we have family and everyone has a family. Okay. So, we have father, mother, brother, sister, and baby. We will have to write an essay about my family. So first see that how many things are important for writing the essay. First, we will have to write our family members. Okay, father, mother, brother, sister, and baby. Dear student, you will have to write that where do you live? What does your father do? What's your mother? Okay, what's your mother do? Is she a housewife or a working woman? You will have to write it. How many siblings do you have? Okay, it means how many brother and sister do you have? You will have to write it. Okay, so these are very important things that you in first paragraph you will have to write that where do you live? What does your father do? What's your mother? How many siblings do you have? Okay. Now, in second paragraph, you will have to write that how is your family? Is your family loving or caring, cooperative and helpful? Okay, you will have to tell about your family that your family is loving, caring, cooperative and helpful. Now, write the question that write two paragraphs on the topic of my family. Write two paragraphs on the topic of my family. This is the heading. Topic name is my family. Family is a gift of God. Family is a gift of God. Family is a gift of Allah. Everyone has a family. Everyone has a family. I also have a family. In my family, we are 5 members, including me. We live in Karachi. We are 2 brothers and 1 sister. My mother is a housewife. Now you will have to write here that your mother is a housewife or a working woman. Okay, in this sentence you can write that is your mother is a housewife or a working woman. And my father, you will have to write about your father that my father works in office. Okay. In second paragraph, you will have to write that we are loving family. We are loving family. We help each other all the time. We help each other all the time. We are always ready to serve and help our family. I am lucky to have a good family. I love my family. Okay. Now I am repeating about my family. First, what you will have to do? First, you will have to make two portion, one for your literature side and second for composition side. In composition side, you will have to make the title page composition side. Okay, then you will have to write the heading or title page essay writing. Then on the next page, you will have to write the question, write two paragraphs on the topic of my family. Okay, then write the heading my family. Then write first paragraph, my family. Family is a gift of Allah. Everyone has a family. I also have a family. In my family, we are 5 members, including me. We live in Karachi. We are 2 brothers and 1 sister. My mother is a housewife. And my father does the work in office. Okay. So this is the first paragraph. And in second paragraph, you write, we are loving family. We help each other all the time. We are always ready to serve and help our family. I am lucky to have a good family. I love my family. Okay. Now, dear student, I hope that you have understand the topic. You must write this activity in your fair copy composition site. Okay. Now, dear student, now open your book. Okay. Active English 3 course book. Active English 3 course book. Okay. Unit number 3, the earthworm, page number 32, course book. Page number 32, course book. But before starting the lesson, I am telling you the learning objective of this unit. Okay. By the end of the lesson, the student will be able to read the text with correct pronunciation. By the end of the lesson, a student will be able to read the text with correct pronunciation, write the meaning of difficult words, to explain about earthworms, okay? And you will have to write the answer of given question, okay? Write the answer of given question. Now, I'm doing the activity. First, I will introduce the topic. And by the help of this activity, you can easily understand the topic. First, see the screen. There are different kinds of animals. Okay, there are birds, animals, or pet animals, wild animals. Okay, so these are the animals. So first, see on the screen that these are the pet animals. Pet animals you see around your home, and you can, okay, like a hen, rooster, goose, cows, chick, rabbit, cat, okay, duck. So these are the examples of pet animal. Okay, now I'm talking about wild animals. You can see in the zoo also they live in the jungle, okay, in the forest. Wild animals live in the forest, okay, like tiger, zebra, giraffe, chimpanzee, monkey, fox, okay. So these animals live in the jungle or forest, and so these are wild animals. Now, this is also kind of the animal birds. Okay, you see the birds, sparrow, parrot. Okay, so these are the birds. Fish. Okay, there are different kinds of fish, color fish, and insect. Okay, ant, bee, butterfly, bug, caterpillar, cockroach. So these are the insects. So why I'm showing you these pictures? Because these are the animals. Or I will teach you about the kind of animal insect, okay, the earthworm. So first the activity is reading, okay, reading the activity. So for this you will have to open page number 32. Open page number 32. The topic name is the earthworm. First I will read this chapter. Please listen me very carefully. First question is that what creature have you seen in a garden? What creature have you seen in a garden? What type of creature you can see in a garden? Can you give me answer? Can you think about it? And what did they look like? And how did they move? For example, in the garden, you can see the butterfly and insects. So we start reading page number 32. What are earthworms? Earthworms are found living in soil. They are brown or red in color. They can grow to different length. Earthworms do not have bones, arms, or legs. They also do not have ears, nose, or teeth. Okay, we have legs and arms and bones, and human being and other animals also have bones, arms, or legs. But earthworm is an insect, and this does not have bones, arms, or legs. They also do not have ears, nose, or teeth. What is the function of ears? Of course, we can hear from ears, and we can smell from nose, and we can chew the food or anything from the teeth. So, but the earthworm do not have ears. Earthworms cannot make any sound, but they are able to see light and feel touch. I'm repeating that earthworms cannot make any sound, but they are able to see light and feel touch. Earthworms live for a few years. They have a way to regrow damaged body part such as their tails. These little creatures are harmless and hurt no one. It's mean that the harmless mean that the, this creature, this heartworm cannot give, is not in danger and not give any hurt, okay, any harm. However, they are often eaten by birds or small animals, okay? Small animals and birds eat the earthworms. Now, the question is that where can we find earthworm? Look around the garden after it rains. Sometimes you can see tiny holes or little piles of dirt. These are where earthworms live. Some earthworms live near the top of the soil, but some live deeper below the ground. Okay. Why are the earthworms useful? Earthworms may be small, but they can move dirt and dig tunnel in the ground. It means they can move in soil and dust, and also dig the holes in the ground. They dig allow rain, and they can even cause big rocks to shift through their digging. The tunnels they dig allow rain and air to go in the ground. This improves the soil and helps plant grow. Okay, so the earthworm, what did we understand? That the earthworm are very useful. There are many advantages of earthworm. That first one, that they are beneficial for growing the plants. Okay, and they are very useful. They dig allow rain and air to go in the ground. We need earthworm to help our food grow. Okay, we should try not to step on them or use them as a fish food. This is the earthworms are fish food, and fish eat them. And earthworms may be small creature, very small creature, but they are very important. Now, dear students, I am explaining this unit, this chapter. What did we understand? You can see on the slide that what are the earthworm. You see the shape. Okay. The earthworm are living in the soil. The earthworm are living in the soil. We can found the earthworm in the soil. Okay. And I'm talking about the colors. How many colors you can see of the earthworm? The red and the brown. Red and the brown. Okay. And also I'm talking about the grow. They can grow to different length. Okay. Small and long. They are growing to different length. They can grow to different length. First, I have told you the colors. There are two colors of red. We can find two colors of earthworm. Number one, red, and number two, brown. And also, they can grow to different length. Yes, now I'm talking about body parts. Earthworms don't have bones. The earthworms don't have bones, arms, legs, ears, nose, teeth. So, dear student, all human beings and animals, and they have bones, arms, legs, ears, nose, teeth, but earthworms do not have these body parts. Okay, remember that earthworm do not have these body parts, bones, arms, legs, ear, nose, teeth. By the help of legs, we can run, walk, okay, but the earthworm do not have legs. Ear, we can listen and hear by ear. So earthworm does not do not have, so earthworm cannot hear. And by the help of nose, we can smell. And by the help of teeth, we can chew. So earthworm do not have, worms do not have nose. So they cannot smell and they cannot chew the food. Now I'm talking about the abilities of earthworm. That the earthworm cannot make noise. Earthworm can see and feel, feel and touch. Earthworm can see, feel and touch. Earthworm can regrow damaged body parts. Earthworm can regrow damaged body parts. So dangerous earthworms are eaten by birds. Earthworm are eaten by birds and small animals, okay? And where can we find, earthworms? We can find earthworm in the soil, okay? So I told you, earthworms are found living in soil. I told you about the colors, that they are brown and red in color. Okay, and they can grow to different length. And also I told you that earthworms do not have bones, arms or legs. And they live in a tiny holes and little piles of dirt and top of the soil, deep and deeper below the ground. Now, I'm telling you that why are the earthworms useful? Earthworms dig tunnels in the ground and they caused big rocks to shift through digging and allow rain and air to go into the ground. Earthworms allow rain and air to go into the ground. And earthworms improve soil. And it is very beneficial to growing the plants. It helps to plants to grow. Okay, so these earthworms, so that earthworms are useful for these things. Now I'm telling you the important points about earthworm. That earthworms are little harmless creature. Little are harmless and hurt no one. Okay, and hurt no one. And small but very important. And earthworm help our food to grow. And we should not try to step on them. We should not use them as a fish food. So, dear student, I am sharing the verse meaning. Write the meaning of following verse. Number one, found. Word is found. It means to search. Grow, become larger. Grow means become larger. Damaged, it means harmed or injured. Damaged means harm or injured. Creature means living organism. Harmless, not causing harm. Tiny mean very small. Tunnels mean underground. And improve mean to make better. Improve mean to make better. I am repeating the words meaning. Number one, found. It's mean to search. Found mean to search. Grow mean become larger. Damaged mean harmed or injured. Creature mean living organism. Harmless mean not causing harm. Tiny mean very small. And tunnel mean underground. And improve mean to make better. Dear student, you know very well that you will have to write the meaning in your copy. But first you will have to make the title page of unit number 3, the earthworm, and you will have to write the new words. Check out new words, at least 10 words from this unit and write it. Okay. Then on the next page, write the words meaning. Okay. Then now I am sharing question answer of this lesson. What are earthworms? Earthworms are tiny creatures that live underground. Earthworms are tiny creatures that live underground. Question number 2, where can we find earthworms? Earthworms live in the soil. Some of them live near the top and some deeper below the ground. Question number 3, can earthworm regrow their body parts? Can earthworm regrow their body parts? Answer, yes, earthworms can regrow their body parts such as their tails. Dear student, check the screenshot. Question number 4, earthworms are eaten by whom? Earthworms are eaten by birds or small animals. Question number 5, are earthworms able to see and feel? Are earthworms able to see and feel? Answer, yes. Earthworms are able to see light and feel touch. Yes, earthworms are able to see light, feel, and touch. Question number 6. Question number 6, how long does earthworm live? How long does earthworms live? Answer, earthworms live for few years. Earthworms live for few years. Question number 7, why are earthworms useful? Answer, earthworms dig tunnels in the ground which allows rain, air to go into the ground. This improves the soil and helps plant grow. Dear students, take the screenshot because you will have to do this work in your copy. Please take the screenshot. I'm showing you the previous one also. Question number 1, 2, 3. Again, please take the screenshot and you will have to do in your copy. Fair come. Okay, now I'm sharing the home task with you. Read page number 32 and 33 of course book. Okay, you will have to read the page number 32 and 33. Again, you will have to read because inshallah ta'ala, I will continue this chapter, okay, in next class. So you will have to read page number 32 and 33. Of course book and complete the activity of page number 34 and 35. Okay, course book page number 34 and 35. This is the reading comprehension, very easy task, because you will have to just circle the answer that support the statement. Okay, and I have told you that you will have to write the new words in your copy, but before you will have to make the title page of this unit, unit number 3, the earthworm, and in next page you will have to write the at least 10 words, new words you will have to write, and you will have to take out and underline new words from the page number 32 and 33 and write it. And on the next page, you will have to write the words meaning. I have explained and shown you. And after that, you will have to write the question answer. Okay. This is the reading comprehension page number. I'm showing you the reading comprehension, circle the answer that support the statement. Very interesting and very easy task for you. You will have to circle it. Okay, read the statement and circle it. Page number 34 and 35. Now, it is time to Allah Hafiz. Have a nice day.